to maybe make myself seem even a little more technical. And so I still, to this day, remember the first customer visit that I made at Bell Atlantic Mobile was to go see Dun & Bradstreet out in the Lehigh Valley in Pennsylvania. And what we showed at that meeting, we took a Motorola SE3 bag phone. I'm going back here for some of you, and some of you won't even know what I'm talking about. It's like when I tell my kids the world's before VCRs and now DVDs. But a Motorola bag phone to, and I still remember the part number, an S1936C cellular connector, which used to fake dial tone for the modem, and hooked it up to a Mitsubishi F10 fax machine, a portable fax, and we sent a fax across the wireless network, and people's jaws just dropped to the floor. And so that was wireless data in those days. And that's why it's such a privilege for me to, I guess, one, have lasted long enough to see some of the things that we always believed would be real and in the marketplace, you know, actually come true, and just the incredible journey that the industry has been on. You know, as part of that role, after that, Sierra Wireless, anybody here from Sierra tonight? No? I was carrying around a wooden mock-up of what the first CDPD modem would look like for about a year and a half and showing that to customers, saying we're actually going to be able to plug these things into our laptops and transmit data. So again, it's just it's so much fun for me to still be a part of this industry. I can't imagine being anywhere else for how exciting it is, what we're going through. And you know, you talk about things like the smartphone. The smartphone was that thing that was about to happen all the way back from, you know, when we first saw the Newton as a device that had handwriting recognition. But so fun for me to experience some of these things coming to fruition. Really what I wanted to share with you tonight was my perspective on the evolution of this mobile experience, and it's constantly evolving. So think back to when you got your first phone. I got mine, I think it was 1987 or 88. Paid $1,200 for it. It was installed in my car, and it did one thing. Not very well. It did voice calls, but it dropped an awful lot of them in those days. But being in sales, I felt the need to have it. So we started out with voice, which, you know, people still want to debate what the killer application is. The killer application is connectivity. It's no one app, and voice was the first example of being able to take that connectivity you were used to having in certain places and unleashing that to be, you know, in a much broader area. Well, then we went to messaging. I remember when we rolled out CDMA at Bell Atlantic in Boston, how I was just amazed at the fact that there was a little light that would show up on the display that would tell me if there was a voicemail. You know, before it was you'd go to make a call, and as the phone would dial, you'd hear a little dit-dit-dit in your ear, and you knew you had a voicemail waiting, but there was no visual indication.